Is it possible to maintain one's hair with platelet-rich plasma and minoxidil alone? No finasteride. Suppose that I'm content with what I have now. Is it possible to maintain my hair long term with repeated PRP and minoxidil? I'm 24 years old with male pattern baldness. My hair loss started early, but I'm started treatment early too. I've been taking finasteride and minoxidil for years, but I've come to realize that finasteride has been building up side effects as to heavily influence my life. Therefore, I'm looking for alternative treatments, among which PRP interests me. Any advice would be appreciated.
Thank you for your question. You're 24 years old and you've been taking finasteride and using minoxidil for several years to treat your male pattern hair loss, and you're expressing concern that there is an impact on your general sense of your health and well-being from finasteride. So you're asking, can you sustain your hair with minoxidil and PRP? Well, I can certainly give you some guidance with this question. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I'm also the founder of Trichostim Hair Regeneration Centers, which is a treatment that we've developed in our practice, which uses PRP in addition to other elements and methods to help people with male and female pattern hair loss. So, to understand a little bit further the benefits and limits of different medical therapies, I think that if you had responded to finasteride, then being off of finasteride, essentially you are going to affect the DHT sensitive hair follicles. But certainly you are in good company because a lot of people are either stopping taking finasteride or will not take finasteride at all. In terms of using minoxidil alone, I think the minoxidil may be a value for thinning hairs, but it doesn't stop the progression, and people can religiously use minoxidil and still progress to continuation of hair loss. Now that brings us to PRP, platelet-rich plasma. We have a lot of experience in our practice with platelet-rich plasma. We use platelet-rich plasma extensively in all our surgeries, for skin rejuvenation, for acne scars, for scar revision, for general skin health, for rehabilitation of injured skin from thermal energy devices. It's very effective in many things, and really, we even use it for dark under eye circles. However, for hair loss alone, in my experience, PRP is not enough. From the feedback I get from patients who come to us, they go for PRP injections for hair loss, and they'll do it monthly. But unfortunately, by the time they get to the fourth month, they start wondering if they're going to need to keep getting scalp injections for the rest of their life. And then they find our treatment called hair regeneration. Now, hair regeneration is a treatment we developed from the use of platelet-rich plasma, or PRP, derived from your blood, a concentration of the wound healing and growth factors, and acellular matrix, which is an advanced wound healing material that really does a remarkable effect on wound healing in areas of the body where cells don't normally would heal by what's called mitosis, but rather they would heal by scarring. Now, this was an incidental finding. Now, this technology, this material, for example, if you were to place acellular matrix on muscle where there's an injury instead of scar tissue, you'll actually induce the healing with muscle. So from a biological standpoint, it's remarkable. It's through the activation of your adult stem cell wound healing response. When originally used to help people heal from transplant and to improve graft survivability, it was observed that thinning hairs became thicker. So in our practice, we do this treatment called hair regeneration for patients who come from around the world. And essentially, it's a one-time treatment for most people, with some people who have more moderate to severe hair loss, I'll do a second treatment as a way to boost the benefits of the first treatment. It doesn't mean that you need the second treatment, but we have so much experience with this material and this process that we found that a second treatment somewhere around 12 to 18 months has been of benefit. After that, people continue to grow hair, and they do. 99% of both men and women see a response. We follow our patients for years, and we have seen that 5 years out, people are not regressing. So there is an opportunity here for you to have an alternative to finasteride, which, by the way, the majority of our male patients who come to us, more than 90% will not take finasteride. In fact, closer to 99%. And therefore, we know that the treatment works independent of pharmacologic support. So I think it's important you learn more about treatments like this. In addition to the PRP benefits, I don't disparage anyone who's using PRP for hair loss, but certainly we have the track record to show that our method actually has brought PRP treatment to a different level, which we call trichostem hair regeneration. So learn more and move forward with an intervention, because the earlier we catch somebody, the better it is. When we tell people that as long as you have a hair follicle, there's opportunity. The loss, once hair is lost, it's no longer salvageable. So the earlier we catch people, we're treating people as young as 18 years old, men who are as young as 18, and women who are actually in their 20s. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question.